Hello, everyone. So I'm Abhinav. I work for SAP in Bangalore. And today I will be presenting a topic of using embedding business rules in the Cloud Foundry IoT applications. In this topic, basically, I will be talking about how to use the business rules in IoT applications, but the concept of using the business rules remains the same and can be applied to other applications which are not exactly an IoT application. So for this session, I have taken IoT use case as a lead scenario, but it also talks about how you can use the business rules for achieving this. So what is IoT in a nutshell? There are multiple devices which are connected to the internet and sending the data. So there may be multiple use cases for it, like you have your refrigerator, which is intelligent, which is sensing how much quantity of food you have, and if something goes down, it sends a request to the supermarket to send it to you. Similarly, in your car, there are multiple sensors which are sensing all the data one by one, and if something is wrong or exceptionally varying from what is supposed to be the standard, it books a service for the vehicle and informs the driver when it has to be taken. Similarly, your health devices, so you have the health bands, which is continuously monitoring your health data, and as and when something is wrong, it informs you so that the corrective measures can be taken and appointment with the doctor can be taken. So in the nutshell, IoT or Internet of Things are multiple things which are connected to the cloud and talking to each other to get the result. So it is predicted by 2020, there will be 30 billion devices in the IoT network. So that means there will be 30 billion devices which are connected to the internet and talking to each other. The main point over here is all the devices are sending all their data to the cloud for processing. So imagine that means 30 billion devices are sensing the data every second. So your heartbeat, your cars, all the parameters are sensed every second. And then it is sent to the cloud for processing. So this means 30 billion devices every second or even lesser than that, sending the data to the cloud for further processing. Now coming to the problem with this kind of scenario is there's an overloaded cloud. So that means all the data is always reaching to the cloud, whether it is required or not required. So maybe let's take an example of your car. So if you have a car which has the sensors in the tires to identify what's the air pressure, and if the air pressure is below a threshold or above a threshold, then it's a critical situation where you need to take an action. But majority of the time, it will be under the range which is required by the, or which is prescribed by the manufacturer. In that case, that data need not be sent to the cloud, and because it's just a noise, which is just adding more and more work for the cloud. Similarly, the simple data enrichment is also happening at the cloud. So what I mean by data enrichment is let's assume you had a software program which is written in to measure the temperature in degree centigrade. Now you have the sensors which are measuring it in Fahrenheit or Kelvin or some other unit. Then this data will be sent to the cloud, and over the cloud, this conversion will happen. Now what is happening with all these things happening over the cloud is the cloud is becoming more and more overloaded with the noise, which is actually can be filtered out right away in the edge of the device. The second bigger problem with this is your data processing logic is basically hard-coded in the cloud in a code. So that means if you wrote that my temperature will be in degree centigrade, then that is hard-coded in the cloud. And if your new sensor sends it in a different value, then you need to put a new IT project to convert it or do it. So the business user, though he knows that my new sensor is having the values in some different unit, but he cannot do anything without an IT project to be implemented to do this simple conversions. So the business user actually is not able to react to the changing requirement. So these are the two major problems with this current setup. The cloud is always overloaded and the data processing is hard-coded in the cloud code, cloud application code. So the possible solution which we have prototyped is basically pushing down the data processing to the device or the edge. So what I mean by this is you push down your data processing to the edge. So edge becomes smart, or edge knows like what is basically an event for it, which requires an attention, which need to go to the cloud so that the cloud application can take an action for it. And other data, which is noise, it just gets filtered out in the edge itself so that the cloud doesn't even know about it. The second thing is basically empowering the business user to react to the changing business. So let's go back to the same example which I was talking about, that you had a program which understands the temperature in degrees centigrade, and now your new sensor sends it in a different unit. Now the business user should be able to program it so that automatically it converts the data before it reaches to the cloud in the degree centigrade. And the business user should be able to do it on his own without any IT thing. So basically, if I sum up what we discussed till now, is basically two kind of scenarios. One scenario is basically the thinning use case. That means you filter the unnecessary noise at the device or the edge level itself. And second is the enrichment use case. So by filtering use case, the example which I have captured here is only if the room temperature is above 27 degrees centigrade, then publish an event to the cloud. Otherwise, don't do anything because it's of no value to us. The second enrichment is basically the data conversion and supplementing the data. So supplementing the data is like adding some status value to it. Like if something is going to the cloud, you just add some status at the edge level itself. And to empower the business user to change it is basically we are suggesting to use a business rules. So business rules basically provides the user with a capability where a business user can change it. So one of the example is a decision table where it is written like if the temperature of the tire, if the tire number of the tire is equal to 1, so that means it's the first tire, it's like your front tire, and the air pressure of the tire is less than 26 or the air pressure of the tire is more than 32, then raise an alarm. Otherwise, don't do anything and it just drop it. Similarly, if there's a decision table which just does a data conversion, then you can have like input and then how the output should look like. And now the business user can just come, change the decision table, and then deploy it so that the rules get changed automatically and you don't require an IT intervention. So I will take you through a demo where I will be showing you both the use cases which we discussed till now. So before going into it, like I would explain how the entire setup looks like. So we have the cloud where this SAP IoT cloud platform service is running. And that is connected to an IoT gateway edge. So gateway edge basically connects to the cloud, and this edge has a device. Right? So device is like a physical device, so that's like your car, and then it has like multiple sensors in it. So sensors are basically a logical device, and like device is a physical device. So device is like, you can assume is like a car, and then sensors are the logical device, logical nodes in it. Now the sensor senses the data and sends it to the gateway, and in the gateway itself, the rules are running, and they filter out or do the data conversion, whatever is required, and then only if it is necessary, it gets pushed to the cloud. So that means if there's a noise, it just gets filtered out at the IoT gateway edge itself. So because in the IoT use cases, the rule, the performance is a key, so the rule and the rule engine is running in the gateway edge itself, and the modeling of the rules is actually in the cloud, so the business user just models the rule and he deploys it and it goes and sits in the gateway edge. So what is happening over here is there's an interceptor. So interceptor is something in which gets invoked on whenever a data comes from the device. And you can write whatever you want your custom logic in the interceptors. So what I have done for the demo is in the interceptor I have written that you call the rules so that it takes that decision and accordingly the data whether it gets pushed to the cloud or not. So I will be just jumping to the demo, and this demo basically uses two services. One is SAP Cloud Platform Business Rules and SAP Cloud Platform Internet of Things. So for this demo, I'm using the gateway as the REST gateway. So basically, this laptop acts as a gateway, and then the devices are sending the data, and then this desktop basically acts as a gateway where the rule engine is running and processing the data. In the real world, this will be based on either MQTT or Modbus, the protocols. So I have already started my gateway. And if you see over here, I am sending a call to 151. So 151 is basically like a device. And then this is a logical node address. This is a sensor. So what I'm trying to tell is for device 151, for the sensor 2, this is the value. And this measure ID tells the type. So now what you can consider it is like car number 151, tire number 2, has a 33 as the pressure of the air tire. And this measure ID basically tells whether what's the unit. So 2 is basically for air pressure. Similarly, like that is predefined. So now I'll be calling this. And it shows 200 OK. So this is basically the IoT cockpit where I can monitor the values. So if you see for 151, so for this node, I have received the data, and I will just check the gauge. So it came like zero because we have filtered the data. So I will just put it on the real-time measure. So as soon as we keep on sending the data, it will start appearing over here. So now if the air pressure is something like 39. Okay. Okay, let me just check. Resend the data, ideally it should show me over here the value. It should get plotted. I think there's some problem with the network speed or with the network speed over here or something. I'll just try to repush the values. Okay, so I am seeing for something wrong. What I am sending is basically for 151, and what I was checking is 142. Let me just recheck it. Okay, it's on the top. So if you see the value 40 came, and now I will just put it for real-time measures. So the value 40 came over here. Now I will just change it to something like 38. So if you see, this value should get plotted over here. And these are the values which are of interest. So basically, I have defined a rule where I have told that the value between 28 and 32 is what is normal. Else everything is basically an alarming situation which need to be reported. So I will be sending 31 over here, and if you see the data that got dropped and I just didn't receive anything for it. But if I just redo it and put 35, then actually the value gets populated. So if you see over here, the value never reached to the cloud because it was not a critical situation, and if we would have sent it to the cloud, it would have of no use. Now, how I have done it is basically I have this air pressure rule. So this is basically a cloud environment where the business user can deploy the rule or model the rule. So for tier number two, I have told that less than 26 and more than 32 is only the critical situation. Let's change it something to 30. So now the business user is able to change the rule and then he deploys it. So now if the air pressure is even 31, it should actually reach to the cloud. So if you see now 31 is reaching, earlier it was getting filtered out. So what has happened is I have modeled the rule and then deployed it. So at that time that it came to my net edge, where this rule is getting processed, and I'm filtering whatever is not relevant to me. So now moving to the second scenario where we have the simple data conversion or the enrichment use case. So here, again, I have a device number 251, which has a logical sensor number one, and it is sending the data. It is sending basically the temperature and in the unit which it has. So if you see the 400, which is basically the value, my type is one, which basically defines that it is the temperature in degree centigrade, and Fahrenheit basically actually tells what is the unit of this. The problem with this is I expected in my cloud that everything will come in degree centigrade, but now it is coming in Fahrenheit and this need to be changed. So I've already deployed a rule which takes care of converting it. So what I would do is I will send the data for device 251. And if I come over here. For 251, if you see the gauge, it automatically got converted to 37.78, which is equivalent in degree centigrade, and came. If I send it in Celsius, maybe 41. So basically now I'm telling that 41 in degree centigrade, and then it should not get converted. So if you see, the last value is coming as 41 degree centigrade over here. So how we have done is, I have deployed another rule over here. Which is called temperature conversion rule. And if you see this rule, it has basically tests the unit of the input, and here we have written is equal to Fahrenheit, and then do the some conversion. Is like percentage is basically a wild card, so it's like, if anything, then return the same thing. So that's why there was no changes for the centigrade. Now, if a business user finds that there's another sensor which is sensing in different unit, then what he can do is he can write another the rule over here, so is equal to Kelvin, and then it becomes value of the input minus 273.15, which is the formula. So what happens is if unit I give it as Kelvin, then it this rule should get fired. So the idea over here is Earlier, you had to implement an IT project just to do all these things, but now the business user is empowered and he can just write his own rules and do it. And even if you see over here, it just gives you all the possibility of what need to, what all you can do, and then you just write your rule. And even if you read it, it is very English-like, like unit of the input is equal to Kelvin. Then do something. So it gives you a very English-like structure to express your rules. Now I would just go and activate or deploy this. So at this time, it is actually getting deployed to my gateway edge where it is running. And now if I send it in Kelvin, the value is 300. Then I should get, I got the value changed, the converted value. So if you see, by using the business rules, expressing the logic was much easier. And how the business rules, basically, if you were wondering how we got the vocabulary or the content as it was working, is basically you have to define your data objects. This acts like a vocabulary on which your rule runs. So I've just defined that I have an input which takes the unit and the value. And then I have an output, which basically gives the how your output will look like. And when you invoke the rule, basically what you do is you pass these values from the data object and give you the rule name, which runs through it. So jumping back to my PPT. So this is how the overall architecture looks like. So you have the devices which is connected to the gateway edge where the rules are running, which basically does all the filtering or the basic conversion. And if we find that it is required to reach to the cloud, then only it reaches. And in the required format, whatever is required, like all the conversion, all those things happened already in the gateway edge. And then in the Cloud Foundry, we have the user interfaces, which basically can be used by the application user to develop its thing. But now the point is application user only gets the data what is relevant to him. He doesn't get all the noises from the device, which is not required. And secondly, even on the IoT services, like when it reaches the cloud, you can use the rule engine to express your logic so that it can be easily changed by the business user without requiring much of the IT intervention. So that's all for today's talk. This is my contact address. Sasi is not here today, but his contact address is also there. He works with me, he's my colleague. That's all, thank you. And I'm open for questions. Pardon? So Rule Service is a service in Cloud Foundry, and IoT is another service in the Cloud Foundry.
The Cloud Foundry application is embedded in SAP.
Yeah. So basically, that's a service running in Cloud Foundry, in SAP Cloud Foundry.
Now, one can develop his own application using Cloud Foundry, using the SAP Rule Engine reserves.
Okay, so basically business rules is a separate service, so technically you can use it with other IoT, other applications also. But the thing is, currently when I was doing deploy, it was running within the gateway edge. So over here you will be making an HTTP call to the rule service, it will be giving the result and then you can consume it.
No, my question was, I understood that part. But is it also possible for me to develop a Cloud Foundry application that use the SAP Rule Engine provided analytic results as a service.
Yes.
To the Cloud Foundry application.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Thanks.
Because rule service is a separate service on the cloud platform which can be used independently. Yes.
On the edge, you don't have the Cloud Foundry thing running, right? How did the rules, what was the ecosystem there on that side, on the edge gateway side?
So the edge gateway, what we have done is basically when you deploy it, I get the rule, corresponding rule at a particular file system in my location, and then the rule engine reads from that particular thing. So rule is basically more like a macro, so you have a rule engine, and then the whatever you've modeled the rule basically is like a XML or a macro, which gets downloaded, and then my rule engine, again, which is running in the gateway edge, reads from that particular location.
So it's just a custom application which you've written on gateway to actually get the
yes,
rules.
Yes, so gateway, so if I go back to the thing, so gateway provides this interceptors. So interceptor gets invoked whenever some data flows in. So what I have written is when the interceptor gets called, then invoke the rule, whatever is there.
Somebody else has to write the gate. I mean, I have my own gateway, so how do I use that? So I need to borrow that code from you, rule engine and IoT interceptor and rules?
So basically, the idea over here is the rule service is a separate service, so you can just invoke it. So how it goes is basically I can show it to you. So if you see, the rule can rules is a service rules is actually a service, so you have to actually endpoint, and then you can actually give the payload. So this is how you can consume the rule engine. Now, because you are using your own gateway, so you have to ensure when you trigger these rules. So basically, if you need to have something like this interceptor, okay, at that moment you need to just trigger it. As of now, no, because what I have done is whenever you click a deploy, the corresponding thing comes down to my system. So I am not making a call because IoT generally need to be a high-performance system, but yes, theoretically you can make a call or...
So macro gets downloaded as the interceptor, and interceptor executes that macro.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
As of now, but yes, you can actually make a call to cloud. But only thing is the performance will be a little bit of problem.
That defeats the purpose of sending a data to the cloud, right? Essentially, if you did the service call.
So if there are no more questions, then thank you.